welcome Nobel Laureate and our sister in Islam, Tawakkol Karman. We'd like to read the award to you.
Thank you.
The Council on American-Islamic Relations, Greater Los Angeles Area, presents this Champion of Freedom Award to Tawakkol Karman in recognition of your commitment to human rights, freedom of the press, and women's empowerment, November 18th, 8th, 2014.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Look, my English isn't strong. I will do all my best. So if I did any mistake, please forgive me. Dear brothers and sisters, I am so proud to be here with you, to participate with you on dreaming on how to practice freedom and dignity and equal citizenship and rule of law, as well as democracy. I came from Yemen while Yemen suffered from a lot of problems, a lot of sacrifice, a lot of crises that attack dream of people, struggle of people who made the great peaceful revolution in 2011. They made a great peaceful revolution for creating a new Yemen, for creating a better Yemen. They made their great revolution because they listened to Dr. King when he said, "I have a dream." So people in Yemen has a dream and sacrifices for their dream and achieved one of the steps of their dream, which is step down the dictator Ali Saleh. And now they are sacrificing for their dream also on building new Yemen, free Yemen, equal citizenship in Yemen, democracy in Yemen, peace in Yemen, love in Yemen, rule of law and democracy. The same thing is with all the people in Arab Peninsula, especially in Arab Spring countries. Youth there, they had their dream and sacrificed for dream. And they could step Ben Ali and Mubarak and al-Qaddafi and inshallah very soon Bashar al-Assad. So people in Yemen now and in all Arab Spring countries, they dream as well as you or the people in America, the grandfather and grandmother in America, that they had dream. So as American people has their fathers' foundations, al-aba' al-mu'assisin, foundation father, is it? True? The translation true? So as people in America has their al-aba al-mu'assisin, the founder fathers, people in all Arab Spring, now decided to be the fathers and mother of building their states. I will not talk about a lot about Arab Spring and about the dreams there, because most of you know, and because I will come again to this city and to speak with you again about that when we win against the counter-revolution. So now, Arab Spring countries faced counter-revolution, faced cause against all the dreams, all sacrifices of the people there. Because of that, I will not talk about our winning in the first step, which is a step down the head of the regimes, because all of us decided to continue our peaceful revolution, and inshallah, coming year, I will tell you the complete story of successful revolutions in our countries. Today, I will tell you about the slogan that Sheikh told us today, making America better. It's a very, very important slogan that all of you has to rise, making America better, because all the people around the world needs America to be better. Yes, all the people around the world needs America to be better. We need the America of George Washington. We need America of Martin Luther King. We need America of Eisenhower. We need America that based on values, on principles of freedom, human rights, acceptance, coexistence, love each other, believe in all thoughts and beliefs. We need this America. So when America far away from its principles, all the world be far away. And now we sacrificed because America politics is far away from its principles and values. So now you, as American people, now I'm not talking with Arabian people or Muslims people. No, I'm talking with American people, Muslims, Jews, Christian, unbeliever, all of them. You should make America to be, to practice its values and its principles. We need you to regain America, because America isn't belong to you. It's belong for all the people around the world, because it is the new country. It is the new world. It's the country that create from the people who dream for freedom and dignity. It's created by the people who escaped from their countries to build a new world. And they did. They created a new world. So you have to keep to save the new world that America was born. So as I said, America now, the policy of America is far away from its principle. Not just as America, as a policy, and as some of the people, remember, some of the people that they act as non-American. As they ask that they are foreigner while they have the citizenship of America, of American people. Let me today to speak with you as one of you, to blame you, as a people who came from Arab countries, as a people who born here, and you know, they said we are Muslims, and so, some of them, I'm not talking about all of them, some of them that, yeah, okay, America has a policy and we have a policy. No, you have to be involved in all the policies of America. You have to be good people, good citizen, because you are Muslim and you are American person, and this is your duty, how to save America and how to save the world. the real power of integration of Muslims abroad in all over the world, especially in America, is in implementing of Islam in a real meaning, like good dealing, like hard working, like creating associations and organizations that serve all the people from all backgrounds, from all religions, from all colors, that save them, serve them, working with them, love them. The immigrant here should aware that he is now one of this society that hugged him. And he has a duty in this society on protecting this society and improving this society. He must do and work and do all his best to live in this country with happiness with all the people. He must convey a beautiful image about his origin country and also about his religion. So the first step on integration is to forget the fears from others. Accept each other. Don't blame him or her, his or her. Don't blame them because they have a bad image about you. No, blame yourself. Why did I do for change this bad image? What did I give him or give them to change this black image? I believe that all the people around the world, all the people, that they are kindness. They have a lot of sifat, a lot of ghashishuni, yani sifat, a lot of principles, a lot of qualities that is influence, that is inside our religion, our Islam. So anyone who came to the foreign people, to the foreign countries, he must respect this country. He must respect its laws. He must respect that this country tell him you are welcome while he was escaped from dictatorship and from corruption in his country. So you should be a good person, a good citizen here. You should be messenger of America to your countries and messenger of your countries to America. So this is responsibility. What does amana mean in English? أحملكم الأمانة. What is amana? Trust. Amana. Okay. إيش يعني أحملكم؟ سأحملكم الأمانة. So please be responsible. Be responsible on changing the bad image of Islam and of Muslims and of Arab in this country. Please do all responsibility. You can't imagine how we suffer in our countries, how our blood was in the streets. It isn't just for free our countries from dictatorship and corruption. No, it's also to send a beautiful image about our countries, a beautiful image about us, that we are peaceful people. We aren't terrorists. So this is the most important image from peaceful revolutions in Arab countries. We aren't terrorists, we are peaceful people. We want to create the world, the new world, with all the people around the world. So I think that the message was very clear in Arab Spring countries through 2011. But unfortunately, it wasn't clear until some of the bad practices of people who live here and of people who practice Islam in a wrong way, in a wrong fatwas, who killed people under the slogan of religion, while Islam didn't say that we should kill anybody. Our deen, our religion is the religion of peace. So you have to be a good messenger of your religion. So through integration also, you can share customs, you can share cultures. That is very important for international peace. It's very important. We are different. We aren't one. So all of us, why did God create us from many colors, from many religions, from many sectors? Why God create us as a difference? Because this difference is making us rich. So please accept each other and also convey this message to your countries. As I told you, I prepare my letter in Arabic language. Or I didn't say that. But I'll tell you, I prepare it in Arabic language. And they told me that 70% of people here, they are speaking English. So I'm trying to convey my Arabic letter to you. So please fill with every word that I'm talking to you, because this is the message of the people of your countries in Arab region. This is the message of people in Arab countries. Please be good citizen. We need you. We need America to be strong. We need America to practice all its principles, all its values. Please participate in every field in America. Be proud that you are American. Be proud that you are American. And account any government, any people who attack the values of America. Count them, because when you didn't count them, you see what happened in our countries. What is happening now in Syria, it's because the people here, the policy here, the political isn't accountable, because they are far away from its principle. So your eyes must be very open to every mistakes that attack the values and principles of America, and that will not be happen if you be away from political participation, from economic participation, from media participation. You should be everywhere, anywhere. You should be everywhere, anytime. You are a citizen of America. Don't say that we are strange, that we are foreign, that we are not in the Muslims' countries, as I heard a lot of messages. I heard this message here in America and in Europe. They are citizens, and they said, no, we are not belong to this country. What? Why did you come? Why? Stay in your country if you will not participate in a good way. So you are here, you should participate as equal citizenship. If you deal as that you have shortest citizenship, people will deal with you like that. So don't blame anybody before you blame yourself. So please, everybody here, special woman, thank you, sister. Rashida. Thank you, sister Rashida. I am so proud of you. All women in Arab countries, so proud of you. All women in Muslim countries, so proud of you. All women in the world, so proud of you. This is a real woman that we need. Real woman. Real woman that participated in, she didn't participate in her community because she is Muslim. No, she participated because she is first human and second Muslim. So she decided to serve everybody in her community, and she will decide to serve everybody in America. And welcome to the new president of America. The biggest mistake that Muslims people do in foreign or in the Western, that they call these countries, and look, I'm not talking about all Muslims. I'm talking about some of the people who think about that. So my message to them, and my message to the good people, to tell them, stop talking against Western as that they are enemy or they are kafir. This is a bad rule. Don't use kafir. All of us is a human, and all of us has a responsibility to build this new world. This new world belongs to all of us. All of us, from every religion, from every thoughts, should build a new future. We are now in the age of electronic revolution, of equal international citizenship. Now we shouldn't talk about just equal citizenship in America or in Europe or in no, we are demanding for equal international citizenship, global citizenship. So all of us must work for this moment, because it will be very soon. But we should create it now. We should work for it now. The last thing, I will say it in Arabic, and my colleague will translate it. Oh, sorry for that. They told me to speak in English more than Arabic, because 70%, but I will say some word in Arabic. Last thing. بالعربي ها؟ كم هلا يتحدثوا عربية هنا؟ وعذبتوني ليش؟ بس إن شاء الله إني أديت شيء جيد يعني. إن شاء الله أديت شيء جيد. المهم أتمنى على الجميع some please حسام if you help me. It isn't fair, he is very tall. So please don't stand here. أتمنى أن تمضوا يعني معا لبناء وطنكم العظيم أمريكا فهي العالم الجديد.
Again, reminding everyone to join hands, to work together, to build a great nation, the great nation of us here as Americans.
أتمنى أن تعلموا أننا جميعا نتطلع عبركم وعبر بقية مكونات الشعب الأمريكي أن تقدموا شيئا إيجابيا عظيما لأمم العالم. هذا قدركم وهذا قدر الشعب الأمريكي.
I wish and I hope that you will work with other communities throughout America, the diverse, pluralistic America, to present something positive for the rest of the world. This is the hope of the others outside of America, and this is your destiny as Americans.
ستجدون كثير من نخب هذا الشعب ومثقفيه وناشطيه يشاركونكم الحلم ويخوضون معكم ذات المعركة المقدسة.
You also notice, especially American Muslims, that there are many people in America, many of the elite thinkers, activists, leaders, who share the same dreams and values that you share, and they will be more than glad to join hands with you.
في الاندماج بعيدا عن التمييز والإقصاء الذي تحشرون فيه أنفسكم وتم حشركم فيه بقصد أو دون قصد.
This is the way to do integration, positive integration, to counter the attempts of marginalization and self-marginalization that sometimes is imposed upon you intentionally or unintentionally.
عبر ذلك فقط ستثبتون أن الإسلام دين تعايش وقبول وتسامح ومحبة وليس معتقد سياسي انعزالي.
With your actions like that, through that action, you will be able to prove to the world what you know about Islam, that Islam is a religion of inclusion, of tolerance, of peace, of love among all people.
دينا يعلي من قيم التعايش الحضاري لا الصراع ولا الاقتتال الديني ولا الطائفي ولا الإثني.
A religion, Islam is that religion that calls for human coexistence among all people, not into warfare or division or dispute.
وأن المسلمين مواطنين أمريكيين صالحين.
And that American Muslims, like other fellow Americans, are good citizens who are righteous, who care about their country.
وأن مساجدهم ومراكزهم ليست واجهات للتطرف ولا مزارع الاستنساخ وتفريخ المتطرفين.
And that our mosques, as we all know, are the mosques to promote peace, tolerance, not as secret spaces to produce terrorism or hatred.
ناهض كل ما يثير الكراهية بين الأعراق والقوميات والأديان.
Islam rejects all disputes and fights among people on the basis of sect, nationality, or ethnic, or race, or origin.
كونوا قدوة في إشاعة قيم التسامح والتعايش والقبول بين الأديان.
Be the role models for others in promoting tolerance and coexistence among all the followers of various religions.
ناهض الفكرة السلبية عن المسلمين في الإعلام والقوانين.
Counter all this negativity about Islam on the minds of people in the way they perceive Islam, whether in politics, in the public square, or media.
عن طريق التقرب من النخب الإعلامية والثقافية ومد جسور التواصل والتعارف معها.
You can counter that misperceptions by extending your hands to those who are within the various fields of America, if media, thinkers, academics, to make sure we build bridges of understanding.
عوضا عن مقاطعتها وعوضا عن مشاعر الكراهية تجاهها وبدلا عن التقوقع.
Rather than do that, so rather than boycotting and staying away from these agencies, these communities, these groups, or forcing our self-isolation.
عليكم أن تفعلوا ذلك بثقة وشجاعة وإصرار حتى تحققوا هدفكم في إذابة الفواصل والأستار والسدود التي تحول بينكم وبينهم.
Do that with courage, with confidence, so you can succeed in removing the walls and the separation between you and the other.
ذلك سيكبح مشاعر الهداء العداء والقطيعة مع بقية الجاليات والمكونات المجتمعية الأخرى.
Be the role model, be the positive action or positive agent in removing any sources or any reasons for animosity or adversarial relation with others, other religious communities, other ethnic communities in our own shared country.
أخيرا أيها الأحبة أدعو منظمة كير التي شاكرة دعتني إلى هذه الفعالية إلى عقد قمم ومؤتمرات مستدامة للقيادات المسيحية والإسلامية واليهودية من أجل مد جسور المحبة والتعايش معها في أمريكا وفي كل مكان.
And finally or lastly, I would like to thank CAIR for inviting me to attend and be part of their conference, and for inviting and making sure that their conferences and events are inclusive, not only of the Muslim community, but also leaders from the Christian, Jewish, and other faith communities to come together to build these friendship bonds among ourselves.
بإمكانكم بإمكانكم تحظوا بقبول واسع في المجتمع الأمريكي. هذا الأمر مرهون بكم وحدكم.
It's really at the end of the day up to you to to receive wide acceptance in the larger society. It's up to you to make that decision. You can choose whether you can be the key to the solution or the problem.
فاختاروا وتدبروا أموركم والسلام عليكم.
So please choose and choose wisely to make the right decision. والسلام عليكم. الله يذكركم. We received a lot of questions, but I think many of the questions were answered through the talk, the speech that was given by our teacher and our sister and our mentor, Tawakkol Karman. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it a much shorter Q&A session, so you can stay with us. It's only going to be 5 minutes. We'll take two questions maybe from the list, because I think most of the questions were answered. And don't forget, a lot of raffle items will be given out, so a lot of gifts. So stay with us, and maybe you'll be the next one getting that flight to travel anywhere in the world on Turkish Airlines. So just, we're going to have the stage set up.
No, Hassan.
No, we're going to do it without standing. Okay, sorry. We're going to make it easy. So we're going to have two questions, so please have a seat. Just bear with us. We're going to finish very quickly. The first question, Sister Tawakkol, how did it feel being a woman in the Yemeni revolution? كيف شعرتي كونك امرأة تقودين الثورة في اليمن?
English or Arabic?
لا, English, English.
English.
طع راحتك على راحتك اللي بريحك.
ما فيها. إذا هم قبلوا إنجليزيتي سأتحدث بالإنجليزية. بحكي بالعربي.
عربي أنا وأترجم يلا إن شاء الله.
أوكي. كان شعور بالفخر الكبير. شعور من تنتصر ثورته السلمية. ومن ينتصر حاملي هذه الثورة من النساء والشباب.
I felt very proud to see my revolution, our revolution, succeed and be victorious in defeating repression.
لم يكن نصر شخصي لي على الرغم من أن لجنة نوبل كانت متابعة أنشطتي منذ 2006 إلا أنه كان نصر للمرأة العربية وللشباب العربي الحامل لحلم التغيير.
It wasn't any personal victory. It's not a personal victory for me as Tawakkol Karman. It was a victory, a collective, a shared victory for all those who struggled and sacrificed. Although the Nobel Peace Prize came under my name, but the real recipient should have been every young Arab man or woman who were part of the Arab Spring striving for freedom.
النصر الحقيقي كان في مشاركة المرأة في الثورة وقيادتها لكافة تفاصيلها قبل حصولها على جائزة نوبل.
The biggest victory was for being able, being honored to be part of that revolution from the days it started and even before.
كان شعور من يقود التغيير ويصنع المستقبل.
It was a feeling, the feeling that one who is leading for change is doing and trying to bring victory.
No. Leading the change and making the future.
Leading the change and مع بالك خلوا كملي بالانجليزي.
Yeah, that's it.
Next question, inshallah. See, I can't trick her. All right, the next question is, what is the key, what is a key lesson from your experience? ما هو كان الدرس الأهم من خلال ما من خبرتك أو تجربتك في الثورة?
Be initiative, be in the front line, don't afraid from anything. You are the hero who will create the future, who will lead the change. Without you, nothing will change. Be in the front line and say, I am the guy who will put all the solutions against all the crises around me.
خذ المبادرة.
بالعربي. كون علينا أن نكون في الخط الأمامي. علينا أن لا نخاف من الحاضر ولا من المستقبل. علينا أن ندع مخاوفنا جانبا. أن نتقدم ونضحي من أجل مستقبلنا من أجل أولادنا علينا أن نقود التغيير ونصنع المستقبل والدي علمني شفاه الله هو الآن في أوكلاند مريض نسأل الله له الشفاء علمني منذ أنا في سن الخامسة بيت من الشعر إلى الآن أحفظه وحفظت أولادي إذا القوم قالوا من فتى خلت أنني عنيت فلم أكسل ولم أتبلدي أنا هو ذا الفتى أنت هو هذا الفتى أنت هذه الفتى لا تكسلوا لا تتبلدوا قودوا التغيير في أمريكا وفي العالم ترجمة الأخيرة
Basically, she shared, she said she was taught since she was 5 years old by her father, who is ill now, and we all pray for his cure and his full recovery, inshallah. She was taught that when you hear, and basically he recited a verse from a poetry poem that said, when I hear people calling, who is the man for it? Who is the person for it? Who's the hero for it? I would imagine I'm the only one being addressed by that, and I will never be apathetic, and I will never be lazy. So please always think, you are the one who can make that change. You are the one who can make that difference.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. شكرا جزيلا. جزاكم الله خير. أخت توكل بارك الله فيكم.